The given figure depicts the vector diagram of the forces and the displacements in the case of force damped system vibrations. Very nice. Vector A represents the forcing function P is equal to P naught sine omega t. Very nice. That's a very nice. What they have given? They have given this vector A and this is vector B and vector C, vector D. Okay, very nice. So this is your vector A is basically force, what they are going to give you. And vector B represents, vector B represents the y is equal to y sine omega t, that is basically a displacement, okay. And the phi is a phase angle between them. Oh, great, beautiful. So this is the phi is a phase angle. And they are going to be asking what is the vector C and vector D represented for, which kind of a forces they will be. So let me tell you what is the phasor diagram there. We know very well, if we are going to plot the force phasor at any moment time t equal to t, we know very well, this is your maximum unbalanced force and the just lagging by phi, the inertia force will be there. Lagging by phi. And opposite to the inertia force, we will be having a spring force. This is a maximum response. And just 90 degree leading, that's a maximum response of damping force. These all are the maximum responses. So this is your phasor diagram, we know very well. We know very well because if this angle is 90, this will also be 90. So if they are going to be saying this is a force vector, so phi lagging is inertia. So here will be the inertia, just opposite to the inertia, D will be the spring. Just opposite to the inertia is the spring force and the vector D is your 90 degree leading vector, which is the damping force. So vector C is the damping force and vector D is the spring or elastic force, because spring forces are also known as elastic forces. So they are going to say vector C and D represents that the damping forces and the elastic forces. So the right answer for this problem is D.